In Europe, you know, we've been kind of stunned to see this comprehensive agreement on investment coming through and be the European Parliament. Of course, there's been a bit of criticism of it now, but it was just astounding to see, you know, this kind of, you know, prospective legislation that was just completely divorced from any, you know, human rights considerations of any sort.
I mean, I just had it this weekend, people telling me, you know, that they are businessmen and they were just telling me, oh, you know, you're a human rights activist. You guys are always, you know, you seem to live on I don't know, on a cloud. Somehow, if you say you're a human rights activist, people tend to think you're, I don't know, a hippie. You don't think anyone should do business at all, which is obviously not the case. I always try to explain that actually human rights activists may be the most pro-business. I mean, we are just not so happy with people having exported jobs and opportunities to a country, you know, where you can't compete. You can't compete with slavery. You can't compete with forced labor. You can't compete with endless subsidies by the state. When you are living in a free market democracy where, you know, we have the European Commission, the same one that negotiated the deal, that tells you that all those things cannot be done. Obviously, it makes sense. So it's about much more actually than human rights. And the Red Capital story comes in. This was a report done by Hong Kong Watch, an excellent report, explaining, showing how Beijing, after the Umbrella Revolution in 2014 in Hong Kong, started heavily investing in Hong Kong, creating this kind of interdependencies, strategic interdependencies between enterprises, business in Hong Kong and the mainland, and vice versa. And how this actually changed, overturned a very important part of the opinion makers in Hong Kong, those holding the power, especially in business. So obviously this, again, it's a warning sign coming, because if you create these kind of strategic dependencies also in Europe, and already we have them, okay, if we think especially in what is coming now, this kind of green revolution, we all know that we are so heavily dependent on China for the rare earths and all these materials coming in, right? I mean, I think 90% of the solar panel market in Europe is coming from China. We know that those are linked to forced labor and slavery in Xinjiang. But it also means that you give China a very heavy weapon to be used against you if you don't respect, if you don't, you know, oblige to their censorship efforts or to their telling the China story well, or you are critical in any way. So it's a very dangerous game. And actually what we've already seen, if we talk about the CAI, this Comprehensive Agreement on Investment, I mean, their biggest promoters were Germany and France. And Germany obviously has some of the biggest companies working in China. I'm thinking particularly of Volkswagen, who actually has a plant in Xinjiang, and who has been, you know, they just said it, oh, we cannot be sure 100%, you know, that we are not participating in this forced labor scheme. But, you know, we'll just keep operating here as long as it's economically viable. So I think as a human rights activist, but also as a European citizen, I'm asking, how are we in any way benefiting from this other than being all in a way, you know, linked to the horrors happening in China? And there I'm thinking especially of the green economy industry, because under the recovery plan after COVID, we are going to be spending so much public money, tax money, so we've all contributed to that, on this green transition. But if that goes hand in hand with massively importing from China stuff that's been made with forced labor, with, you know, oppression, I think that's horrible, because that's the worst appeasement possible, right?
Hey, thanks for watching American Thought Leaders. As you're probably well aware, big tech has been censoring a lot of content on its platforms, including some American Thought Leaders episodes, including some other Epoch Times content. Now, to deal with this, we've actually launched a new video platform, Epoch TV. Epoch TV is our premium platform for digital video content. It's got American Thought Leaders, it's got Facts Matter with Roman Balmakov, The Larry Elder Show, Crossroads with Joshua Philip, And frankly, this is our contribution, if you will, to the uncensored media landscape, which is something we really, really need in this country and around the world, frankly. To subscribe, epochtv.com/ATL. Go to epochtv.com/ATL or hit the link below.